few months ago, I decided to quit doing mods in order to start my own indie game journey. But before I'm able to create a full game, I need to learn, and one of the best ways to practice, in my opinion, is to try to recreate something I already know. That's exactly what I've been doing, trying to create a demo inspired by Hogwarts Legacy. Hey, I'm Arnie, and you're watching my Game Dev Adventure. Now, before we start this video, I'd like to add a little disclaimer. This whole thing is just for a learning purpose for me. I don't own any copyrights to the wizarding world. I am not associated with Warner Brothers in any way. And this demo is not intended to be released. I just want to learn how to do stuff in the Unity game engine and obviously have fun. Actually, it's not even called Hogwarts Legacy in my world. It's called Henwards Legacy. Sorry, babes. Now, I'm what we call in the video game industry a total noob.
A person who is inexperienced in a particular sphere or activity, especially computing or the use of the internet.
Yep, that's me. So it means I'm probably going to make some mistakes, but that's good, that's how we learn. And if you are more experienced than I am in game development and you see something horrendous and disturbing in this video, just let me know in the comments so I can get free education. Okay, let's start with world building. Those of you who followed me before when I was doing mods for The Sims probably know that this is my favorite part of game dev. It brings me back to The Sims 3 creator world, rest in peace darling, and I get to do what I love the most, an open world. So for this map, I actually got a 3D model of Hogwarts online from a team called Open Hogwarts, props to them, and it was probably extracted from an old Harry Potter game. The first thing I did was to prepare the terrain with stylized textures that I got from the Unity asset store. I also added animated grass to make it look a bit more three-dimensional and lively. Then I'm adding the Hogwarts 3D model. It's a bit busy, there are way too many polygons and only a dozen meshes for the whole castle, including the inside. This means it's going to be a nightmare to render for my computer, so I'm just going to take it to Blender and do some remeshing and optimization. It shouldn't take long.
A few moments later.
Okay, this took me forever. But here we are, we have a nice Hogwarts, I mean Henwards castle. I updated some of the old textures with new stylized materials because I don't want this demo to look incredibly realistic. I really like this mixed art style inspired by Life is Strange, for example, because the lighting, in my opinion, is the most important visual feature when you want something to look good and kind of realistic, but not too much. Speaking of lighting, I'm now adding clouds to the scene, and my favorite type of clouds that isn't too expensive for my machine is to have them rendered as a 2D texture with two layers above the world on a dome 3D model. I'm changing the colors and speed of the clouds, and I'm tweaking the sunlight settings to make it look like a sunset. For the trees and the forest, I was looking for a way to optimize it to keep a high frame rate even if I have thousands of trees on screen at the same time. So I used a plugin called Amplify Impostors. What it does is that it creates a dynamic 2D texture instead of rendering the whole tree with a thousand of polygons, and it's not all flat like a billboard texture thanks to a parallax effect that changes the perspective depending on the angle you're looking at. So when you're far enough, you can't see the difference, and it even reacts to lighting. How cool is that? For the inside, I'm only going to work on some parts of the castle, like the Great Hall, Main Tower, and a few outdoor locations. For the Great Hall, I added some floating candles, fire particle effects, lighting, and more. I also created a small mountain far from the castle for the reveal, and other stuff that you'll see by the end of this video. Now, let's talk about gameplay with spells. Now, for the gameplay and code, I'm using a very useful tool that is called visual scripting. It's now integrated into Unity thanks to Vault, but I'm using another one called Playmaker, and what it does is that it allows you to create actions without writing a single line of code, and it gives you a visual interface that is much more simple to understand when you start game dev. We'll take a look at it later. So, for the player, I got this basic character controller made especially for Playmaker, and heavily customized it. And for the character model, I created it using a website called Ready Player Me, because the last time I tried to model a human in Blender, it didn't end well. So this guy is called Kevin. I use him in almost all of my projects. I just change his clothes depending on the game I'm working on. So here I'm going to add his Henwards house to the top. He is a Slytherin. Yes, that's his house. It was confirmed by the author of the Henry Buffer books, the iconic Lady Gogo, that the Slytherin are kind, naive, creative, and obviously... Okay, so now we have Kevin and a nice character controller with a dynamic camera I created that changes depending on the speed he's moving. Now let's move on to spells. The first one I created is an obvious one, Luxos. So when I press tab on my keyboard, Kevin is going to raise his wand that is going to illuminate his surroundings when it's dark with a gorgeous and mysterious blue light. And let me show you how easy it is thanks to visual scripting to create this. In this script, I created three states. Listen to Luxos, activate Luxos, and deactivate Luxos. First, when the game starts, it's listening to a key. This means it's waiting for me to press the tab key that I chose for this action, but you can choose any key you want. So when you press it, you want to go to the next state, that is activate Luxos. So I'm creating an event, end a transition, and now I just link it to the next state, activate Luxos. In this state, the first thing it's going to do is to activate the light that is attached to the wand, then fade its intensity from 0 to 10, so it's a bit smoother than just popping out. And then it's fading the animation layer that is just a pose of the character holding a wand. I chose a layer in the animator, so this pose applies to all of my other animations. So when my character is running or just standing still, he's still doing the pose of holding the wand. Then I'm playing a little sound effect that I really like, and that's it. And finally, I'm adding another listener for the tab key so I can turn the light off and go back to the original state. So, new event, new transition, and the last state, deactivate Luxos. In this final state, I'm just fading the light back to zero, fading the pose back to zero as well, and then transitioning back to the original state. And I'm just adding an action to deactivate the light in this state, so when I load the game, the light is off. And that's it. Now, let me show you how it acts when I hit play. So, you can see the scripts going from one state to another, highlighted in green. Okay, that was an easy one. Now I'm creating a new spell that is a bit more complex, Levitatum. So for this spell, I added a name feature. So when I right click on my mouse, my character is aiming just like in a shooter game, so it's easier to see where the spell is going to be casted. Next, I added a cube that is listening for the spell, and when I left click, it floats in midair. Also, I found a cool spellcasting particle effect on the asset store, and I customized it. Then I added some particle effects below the floating object and an outline around it, so you know when you can interact with it, and voila! And finally, I made it possible to use both spells at the same time, so you can see in the dark thanks to Luxos and still cast another spell. Let's take a look at it during the night. And the best spells I created finally are Hengardium Chicosa to turn an object into a chicken and Abracadabra to capture those chickens, but more about that later in the video. I don't want to spoil the storyline. Before we get into the big reveal, I'd like to talk about today's not sponsor, Patreon. This is happening thanks to my lovely patrons. This video would not have been possible without you, because it took me months to create, and your support throughout these times when I do nothing but learn brings me a stability that allows me to keep working on all of my projects, and I'm really grateful for that. So thank you again. I can't thank you enough. By the way, I'm introducing this month digital goodies. So if you'd like to check it out and show some support, I'm putting a link in the description of this video. And now it's the time to welcome you to Henwards Legacy.
I'm just going to leave some gameplay footage without any comments, and I'll see you again by the end of this video. Enjoy!
Good morning, young wizard. My name is Mona Lisa.
Hello. My name is Kevin.
I don't care what your name is. You shall not pass until you find the password.
Can I just threaten you instead? I have no interest in looking for a password around here for ages.
If you do that, I'm gonna have to tell Lady Gogo.
Watch me.
Wow. I did not expect that.
Any last words?
Yes, I would like to... Oh no. Hey Harry, I have been waiting for you. I need to find some chickens for my potion. Can you help me?
My name is not Harry. It is Kevin.
Well, Harry, you didn't respond to my question. I need those chickens.
Okay, Hagrid, I will find those chickens.
Dear Wizard Harry, thank you for your help. Do you know any spells? That is some shiny stuff you have there.
Indeed.
Okay then. You have the job. I need you to find a magic fish in the castle and turn it into a chicken.
A chicken?
Yes, a chicken, Harry. Just use the spell Hengardium Chicosa to turn the fish into a chicken, and then use Abracadavra to capture it, and bring it back to me. Mommy needs her chickens.
You're saying it wrong. It's not Chicosa, it's Chicosa. Hengardium Chicosa.
That's what I said. Hengardium Chicosa. See you later, Harry.
My name is Kevin. Bitch.
Not you again. Could you lower your wand, please?
Hi. I'm here to make peace with you.
What a pleasant surprise. I thought this day would never come.
Can I get inside you now?
Well, if you have the password, yes, but I should warn you. Oh no.
Are you the filthy fish everyone is talking about? I need to turn you into a chicken for Hagrid.
No, you must be mistaken, it's not me. By the way, what a delightful set of colors on your shirt. That makes me feel most happy.
Do not try to trick me. Are you the filthy fish?
I don't respond to that name and I am not filthy.
Okay then. Hengardium Chicosa. What a beautiful chicken. Abracadavera.
Oh no.
Wow, that was such a quick move.
Thank you, Hagrid. I have your chicken.
Oh yes. The chicken. I forgot about that. You can put it in the cauldron.
Okay, I will put it in the cauldron. Hagrid, can I ask you a question first? Why are there no NPCs in the castle? I feel like I am all alone, even though I had a good laugh with the filthy fish. Hagrid?
I think there are no NPCs in the castle because Arnie doesn't know how to program them yet.
O.M.G. OMG, what? What did you just say?
Yes, I know. This is some disappointing piece of information, innit? But maybe he'll be able to learn for the next video.
Oh my god, Rick Griffin Purr. I seriously hope so. Shall we end the video here then?
Just put the chicken in the backyard. The cauldron is glitchy anyway. And then yes, we'll end this never-ending video.
Agrid?
Yes, Kevin?
Never mind. You remembered my name.
Oh wow! You're still here! What an absolute legend!
That makes me feel most happy.
So many things have happened since I started working on this project back in April. Since then, I first of all shaved my head, I know it's really gorgeous. Then I got to create my indie game company. Also, I became an uncle for the first time, and I got to work on tons of new projects, most recently with AI research. So if you'd like to see more of this, you can follow me on Twitter, subscribe to this YouTube channel, and join my Patreon page where I'm adding to the Digital Curious this month a newspaper in which I get to share the things I discover and create monthly. Thank you so much for watching, for your support, and I can't wait to share more crazy stuff with you. Have a good day, evening, or night. Peace!